What time is it?
It's time to talk about timing. Now, timing is the third of the root five that you're going to want to follow daily. These are very, very easy to do, very easy concepts. Now, timing has a lot to do with hormones. I'm not going to get super deep into hormones, but what you need to realize is that hormones are your friends as well. They're buddies inside of your body, and they really want you to pay attention to them, and they want you to get a rest too. Just like at the end of the day, you know, you get cranky, you're kind of like, oh, I need a nap and all that kind of stuff. Your hormones also need a rest as well. So your timing of your food is extremely important. I'm also going to say this, there's a lot of different options when it comes to timing, but the important thing is that you have a specific timing structure. Now, plain and simple, we have people who are picky eaters. There's two types of picky eaters in this world. There's the one type of picky eater where they don't eat nothing except for the things they grew up with. Super picky. I only like chicken fingers and french fries when I go out to eat. That's why I'm a picky eater. And then you have picky eaters who are, unfortunately, the people who constantly eat. They never sit down and have a meal, and they just pick and pick and pick. Pick, and every time you get something to eat, they're like, ooh, let me get a bite of that. There's those types of picky eaters. Now, when it comes down to it, unfortunately, both are bad. No, I don't say bad. Unfortunately, both will not help you in the goals that you want. And the second one, the latter, is the absolute worst when it comes to making a change and creating, following this rule, this route, creating this route system of timing. Now, to create this route system of timing, you really want to make sure that you have 2 to 3 hours in between your meals. Now, does that mean you have to have five, every single one has to be that way? Every single in between your meals has to be 2 to 3 hours? No. For instance, right now, and your structure can also change. Know that your timing structure, you're not committed to it for the rest of your life. Okay? What you really want to create is just breaks for your hormones to be able to recoup. It takes a lot. We went over it in the last video. It takes a lot to digest food. A lot of energy. So if you're constantly eating and you're constantly picking and you don't have timing structured to your meals and your day and what you're doing, unfortunately what's going to happen is that your system is going to become so tired, your hormones are never going to be given a chance to recoup, and they're going to be really cranky and not do what you want them to do. So be nice to your hormones. Now, I'm going to go over a few different structures that you get to choose from. Oh my gosh, we have choice? Oh my gosh, I don't have to just follow something specific. The thing is that I've done so many different types of eating and I've done so many different types of plans that I know that there are many different things that work. Now, it's putting it all together, which is why I created the Root 5 system. It's putting it all together is what really matters. Now, we're gonna start off with one, I'll move to the next, and then to the next we will get some options. So option one is having those 5 meals a day. Now, you need to think, while you create, when you pick this option, don't think about how much you like food, how much you want to eat. These are the things I want you to think about. What does your day look like? Are you a single mom? Are you constantly busy? Are you a teacher in school? Are you able to eat in the middle of the day whenever you want? Are you a nurse? I've worked with a lot of nurses who work 12-hour shifts. Think about your lifestyle. Think about the type of things that you're going to be doing on a regular basis that will allow you the time slots to be able to chew food rather than inhale it. Right? So you want to be able to have the time to be able to sit down and have a meal or have a snack. So one of the first basic structures, something that you see a lot, is eating every 2 to 3 hours. Eating every 2 to 3 hours. You wake up, you have something to eat, you wait 2 to 3 hours, you have a snack, you wait 2 to 3 hours, you have lunch. And I'm rolling my eyes because for me, it was really monotonous. I constantly felt like I was eating. I didn't enjoy it. I felt like I always had to prep. You have to prep a lot more, and it created so much planning inside of my brain that I felt like my body and my whole life was being taken over by eating food, and I wanted something different than that. It didn't work for me, but maybe it will work for you. Maybe that sounds like a great place to start. Maybe it sounds like that would work great for me. I get hungry quickly. I really enjoy eating food. It's totally doable for me because I work at home. I'm home all day. I'm able to do that. I don't have to do the prep. Or maybe you love prepping. Maybe you enjoy it. Maybe you are a recipe type of person, right? I'm not a recipe type of person. I am anti-planning. I am anti-guilt. I just need a structure that's going to help me out, which is why I created the Root 5, because it's something that I apply to my life daily. Now, That was option one. Every 2 to 3 hours, making sure you, you know, another thing you want to just, I'm just going to throw that in there. Eating late at night, there's been studies back and forth. You don't want to eat late at night, but no one's ever told you why. The reasoning is because you want your digestive system to be able to recoup as well. Because if you just ate something and then you go to bed, unfortunately, you're going to wake up a lot. Even though you feel like you're sleeping, you're going to get a very light sleep because your body's digesting. It's utilizing energy, even though it's trying to replenish its energy. That's a big reason why you don't want to eat close to nighttime, about 2 to 3 hours, you know, give or take. 2 hours to be really safe. But that's the reasoning behind that. There's also been other studies done where it's been totally okay. People have lost weight. People feel fine. Some people sleep better than others. It's something you have to test and apply for yourself. Now, option one, eating every 2 to 3 hours. Option two, let's go to it. This is one I do now. It's the best for me. It's the least amount of planning. I get to have giant meals. It's pretty awesome. I like eating a lot at one time. I don't like eating like a bird when I do eat. So it's called intermittent fasting. It allows even more time for those hormones to replenish. It causes less planning, causes less stress for me. Very easy to do, very easy to get done. Now, the trick with this one is that you need to make sure that you're getting the right amount of calories in during these times. Now, if you're trying to lose weight, your calories will be in a deficit, so you won't be eating as much. But then if you're somebody like me who works out a lot, has big muscle tone, I'm 150 pounds, you probably don't realize that by looking at me, 150 to 155. I'm all muscle. I'm all lean muscle. My muscles need a lot of food. So, intermittent fasting. I don't eat all morning. All morning. I don't eat until 1 p.m. 1 or 2 p.m. around that time, whenever I have that structure. Then I wait 4 or 5 hours, and then I have my meal again, 6, 7, 8 o'clock-ish. Go to bed around 10. Depending on when I'm going to bed is when I'm going to have that other meal. It's how it fits into my schedule. I'm a trainer, I'm a personal trainer at a gym right now. I work from home, I do a lot, I'm busy during the day. Having two meals a day was very, very awesome for me. It fits really great into my schedule. Makes me feel awesome, makes me feel guilt-free, and it's anti-planning, which is why I take that structure. Now, say you're really, really busy at night, you don't really have time for dinner, but you do have time in the morning for maybe breakfast. Intermittent fasting works really, really great because you can have breakfast and then a lunch and then not have dinner. Two or three meals within that time frame. You just want to make sure that there's hours in between. That's all. That's all. You can even go really extreme with your intermittent fasting. You can eat one day, have a 24-hour fast, and eat another day. That's not really sustainable for the long term, but say for a week, if you wanted to try it out, throw it in there, see, you know, people are really surprised when they try this. Intermittent fasting just means you're having more than an 8-hour window, usually a 12-hour window, where there's no consumption of food, just water. No consumption of food, no consumption of anything more than 50 calories within that window. And what it does is it allows for those hormones that I was talking about in the beginning to take a nap, to rest, to sleep, to recover. And you're also giving your digestive system a break as well. So even though you might think, oh, food means energy, I need to eat to get energy, unfortunately, you've been a little mistaken. You gotta eat the right foods at the right timing, in order to be able to get that sustained energy that you're really looking for. So you might think I'm crazy saying you eat one day and then you fast for 24 hours. Fasting has a beautiful place in there. Now, I don't want you to start with that one. That's a little bit more advanced. So if you are a little bit more advanced, go ahead and give that a shot. You'll actually realize you do not get as hungry as you think you would in that 24-hour period. Now, option one, let's go over it again. Option one, you have 2 to 3 hours in between. You have a meal, a snack. Option number two is more of an intermittent fasting. You have a lot of room there, a lot of room. Now, if you want to kind of get into this, say you're used to option number one and you really want to try option number two, there's a transition period that needs to happen. Otherwise, you're going to be starving because your body is used to getting food in the morning or your body's used to getting food at night. And this little trigger goes off that says, I'm supposed to be getting food. What's going on? Why am I not getting food? I'm really, really hungry. What's going on? Oh my gosh. You start freaking out and then you just splurge. You eat all the food and it's all downhill from there, right? We don't want that to happen because then it creates guilt. Let's get rid of that. Okay, so if you're going to be making the transition from option one to option two into intermittent fasting, there's a whole lot of stuff out there on intermittent fasting, and you'll see people who have a specific way of doing it and they're gonna try to sell you on a specific way. And what you'll notice is if you've listened to a few different people gathering information from a few different teachers who are very passionate about teaching it, not just passionate about selling stuff. Passionate about, find passionate teachers, guys. Anything you learn in your life, make sure you're finding passionate teachers and they're talking with passion no matter what. Please, 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 please. I love teaching about this stuff. I love when people get it, that light bulb goes off. It's so exciting for me because it lets me know, hey, that's one less stress in their life. It's one more thing that they get to enjoy about their life, and that's why I do this kind of stuff, all right, guys? So when you're transitioning from one to two, option one to option two, make that window a little bit smaller. Don't start with the 12 hours. You could jump right in, but expect to be pretty hungry, expect to be a little bit cranky, expect there to be this transition where it's not so great. All right, if you want to just jump into it. If you just want to dip your toe into it, just skip breakfast, but then have that first snack. Or have your breakfast where that you would have that first snack. So you do get a bigger meal, a little bit more calories in that first time that you eat. All right? And the biggest thing about your timing is that you're not picking throughout the day. Now, a lot of you guys have built up habits of picking throughout the day. Your body's extremely tired. You're going to be foggy in the brain. You're not going to be thinking clearly. You're just going to be like, oh, I just want a taste of this, a taste of that. And you're just thinking about calories in versus calories out. You're not thinking about your hormones resetting. You're not thinking about creating a system for your body. Your body wants organization. Your body wants a system. It wants to know when it's going to be getting food. It needs a timing structure, and you need to be disciplined enough to create it. I can help you, and I can give you the whys, and I can give you the whats, and I can give you the what you need to do's, but you need to have the discipline to create a system and go for it. Now, it's very simple. Option one or option two, you get to choose. Both of them have been proven to be really, really awesome. Both of them have been proven to help people lose weight. Both of them have been proven to, you know, help people get lean. There's no one way is better than the other. When it comes to hormones, yes, it has been a little bit more proven for the intermittent fasting to work. When option one doesn't work for people, a lot of them switch over to option two, that intermittent fasting one. All right, so if option one is something that you've tried and you've really done, and you can honestly say you have not picked in between your meals, and you really have timed out those foods, you can go ahead and try option two. Or if you've never tried either of those options, go ahead and pick one and start sticking to it. I'm gonna get real with you guys here. You gotta stick to it. You gotta get those timings down. No picking in between. Just, I don't wanna say distract yourself, but do something that's gonna lift you up. So use your timings for work, or I'm sure every single person who's watching this video has gotten into work or something that they love to do, has gotten into a sport, and like hours go by and you're like, oh my gosh, I didn't even realize 17 hours, I'm exaggerating, but you know, 4 or 5 hours just went by. You can get really lost in stuff. If you're passionate about something that you're doing, you can get really lost. So find a really awesome book, find a project to work on, find something that you can do to get your mind off of food. Now, food and fuel, it's not the source of life. It's your attitude towards it that's really going to be the source for you. So creating a timing structure that really supports that, great day, guys. All right? Next up, super excited. Make sure you go to the next one. We're going to go over number 4 next. This one was about timing, just a little recap. You want to make sure you have a structure during your day of timing of when you're actually going to eat. You sit down, you have a meal, you enjoy it. You're in an environment that you enjoy. I am at a job right now. I teach fitness at this building here. You can't really see it in the screen, but I teach fitness at a building here. There's tables all around me for people to eat during their lunch break, to enjoy greenery, to enjoy this lovely fountain behind me. And some people just don't take advantage of it. Enjoy when you're having your meals. Make sure you have timing structure for it. I love you guys. See you in the next video.